The DJ Smooth Breakfast. Only on Massive Metro.
So we still nage the current, the newly crowned Miss South Africa. Sikhumangela phana uTamarin. Seka khona ufikile simamukelile. So besikhuluma naye nje sasigabanzi ukuthi ubani ubuyaphi nokuthi njobe winike this crown kahle kahle uzobe enzani ngerain yakhe. Morning.
Good morning. How are you? I'm very good. Happy to be here.
You all smiles and we're happy for you as well. So yeah, just take us through your upbringing. Where is Paarl and who is Tamarin?
Okay, so I was actually born in Worcester.
Yeah.
And then I moved to Paarl at the age of 9, 10.
Yeah.
Went to primary school there and high school. So Paarl's in the Western Cape.
Mm-hmm.
Very small town. So I'm a small town girl. The community there is very, you know, tight-knit community. Everyone knows everyone. Everyone knows what's going on with everyone. And, you know, just worked hard at school and went to UCT and I'm studying medicine.
Going to be a doctor?
Yes.
Wow. And then you and Patience, how did that come about?
Me and?
Patience.
Yeah, oh, okay. So, as a young girl, you know, people always encouraged me to do it. They told me, go, Tamarin, like, you can do it. You have the personality, you have the stage personality. And I did it for local competitions at school.
Okay.
So, like, my high school, so I was Mrs. New Orleans.
Yeah.
Or my church, I did. And my community, like, Dark and Stain community. That's where it started at a young age.
Okay. And I see you have parents that are teachers.
Yes.
How was that like to be in a household with people that are into education?
Always talking about education.
Yeah.
And my dad loves debating about it. But I'm very passionate about it as well. So, I don't mind.
Yeah.
And I think, yeah. I think that's where I get my passion for education from. And my parents helped me throughout school.
Okay.
They made me understand the importance of education.
Yeah, I see here at some point you became a head girl.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I was deputy head girl at primary school and then I became head girl at high school.
Yeah. University, how is that like? How do you balance being studying for being a doctor and then now being a Miss South Africa?
No, so I have to put the studies on hold.
Yeah.
And I'll go back to that after my, when I'm finished with my job at South Africa.
Okay. Has it sunk in yet that you...
It sunk in.
Yeah.
Finally. The first week was just, like, everything just came in as a storm. And I was like, what is going on?
Yeah.
Why do I have so many interviews and talk shows? And I think it only sunk in when I watched the video myself.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw the crown being put on my head.
Yeah.
Only then I was like, wow, that's me.
I see you like crying.
Yeah, I love it. I love... But there must be garlic bread as well.
Oh, yeah?
Braai vleisie met garlic brood.
Yeah. Yes. And then what's going to be a plan with you going forward? After winning this, it has sunk in.
Yes.
When does the job begin?
The job has already begun.
Yeah.
I think this is a lot to do with it. You know, just inspiring and, you know, encouraging the youth out there. You know that this is possible. You can get to this point with hard work. So that's my message that I'm trying to bring across.
Mm.
But I'm also going to start my own official project and campaign soon. But I have to talk to the organization about that first.
All right. And then maybe for someone whose life changed overnight, how are you handling that?
At first, I will tell you, it was very overwhelming. I had a night where I was just very emotional and I had to call my dad and be like, wow, you know, you prepare yourself, you think you're prepared until it actually happens.
Yeah.
So it's very different from medicine. And I have to, you know, you have to look good every single day. You have to wake up, do your makeup, do your hair. Whereas in medicine, I would just put on my tackies and be like, I'm going to the hospital.
Yeah.
So definitely took a flip, but I'm getting there and I'm really excited for that.
Only on Massive Metro.